We're continuing in Exodus chapter 3 and really looking at the identity of the angel of the Lord. We, in our previous study, just called him Jesus because down through the centuries, all over the world, church preachers and leaders just call the angel of the Lord Jesus so often because it is Jesus as he was before he became a human being like us. But why do we think that? Why is that such a strong view all over the world? Well, let's just read it through. Exodus 3, Moses kept the flock of Jethro, his father-in-law, the priest of Midian, and he led the flock to the back of the desert and came to Horeb, the mountain of God. And the angel of the Lord appeared to him in a flame of fire from the midst of a bush. Just on the name angel, it just means one who is sent, a messenger. And of course, we kind of often just think, oh, angel, that's like a particular kind of creature, a category of creature in part of the heavenly host. But the name angel just means messenger or one who is sent. And we'll remember, of course, Jesus refers to himself in that way in the Gospels. He says, I am the one sent from the Father in the power of the Spirit. So his deep identity is one who is sent. And he loves to do that. He rejoices in the fact that the Father tells him what to do and what to say, and the Spirit empowers him to do it. And so we might think, if you're sent, that's a lesser thing. But Jesus doesn't think so. He glories in it. In his mind, it's a proof of his divinity that he is the one sent from the Father. And when we look at Exodus 3, we see why Jesus thinks that way. So let's carry on. Exodus 3 verse 2. So Moses looked, and behold, the bush burned with fire, but the bush wasn't consumed. And then Moses said, I'll now turn aside and see this great sight, why the bush does not burn. From now on, just note carefully, all the titles that are used for the angel of the Lord who's in the bush. And look here, verse 4. So when the Lord saw that Moses turned aside to look, God called to him from the midst of the bush and said, Moses, Moses. And Moses said, here I am. Then he said, don't draw near this place. Take your sandals off your feet, for the place where you stand is holy ground. We might have a look at that little detail in our next study. But look, moreover, he said, look at this for a self-description by the angel of the Lord. I am the God of your father, the God of Abraham, the God of Isaac, and the God of Jacob. Now, we'll finish the verse off in just a moment, but I heard one person say, well, this is just a created angel delivering that message from the God of heaven. This angel isn't God, but he's just delivering a message from God. Okay, that doesn't sound exactly what's happening, but look specifically at the end of verse 6. Moses hid his face, for he was afraid to look upon God. So the one he's looking at is God, and Moses sees that and is afraid to look at God. So we wanted to take just this little study to appreciate this incident is referred to in the rest of the scriptures, and it's such a critical moment because this angel of the Lord comes to rescue his people, and of course Jesus is the savior, the rescuer, and it's so important for us to realize that, as Jude says, it's Jesus who rescued his people from Egypt.